when I first started, the majority of my material was from salvage yard because, you know, that's what you could afford. You buy it by the pound. And so I just developed this love for industrial scraps, industrial drops, old tools, different things like that. I love the derelict object, the found object. I love old tools, old metal. There's a romance in the found object. I'm influenced a lot, I think, by those objects and by those textures and colors. And then, of course, by, you know, what every artist's life experience and nature. The insects in Florida, amazing. The birds, the fauna and flora, that's figured into the work heavily. When I've always been artistic. I didn't discover metal and sculpture and welding until I was in my late 20s. But once I found it and the pieces came together and it all connected, that was it. There was no question in my mind what I was going to do. Not to say that it just came right out and did it and it was all successful. It is a lot of extreme hard work, and still to this day, I'm married to it. The city of Tallahassee is really doing a lot, I think, for the arts community. Organizations like yours, promoting artists. I believe in the mission. I believe in what they're doing. I've had personal friends affected by HIV, AIDS, that without Big Ben Cares and without that financial assistance for medications and that support, they would have had really dire outcomes. It would have been bad for them. I love to help. That's just my nature is to help people, other artists. If I see a need, I want to fill that need if I can in some way. When you really understand what people go through, and you have an organization like yours, you can't help but want to be involved.